Greetings and salutations, people of the internet. This is Master RBG, and today we have a very special game starring a very special character for you.
Who?
Why, I'm glad you asked. Today we'll be reviewing none other than Owlboy, a game that, to be perfectly honest, spent the better part of a decade in development, which is a bit longer than most 2D games, but trust me, you'll see that a lot of heart went into making this, and that time was well worth it. So without further ado, let's do it, let's play Owlboy. Revered. Exalted. Wise. This is what we owls aspire to be. Over the centuries, we have worked hard to build up the respect that people have for us. And as times get harder, you too, as my student, shall carry the weight of owlhood upon your shoulders. I'll be honest with you, Otis. You haven't been doing too well in your studies at all. So, I've been thinking that perhaps your talents simply lie elsewhere. So today, we'll be doing some flying. I bet you've been looking forward to this for a while. Good. Then listen closely. All you need to do is jump off the ground. Then, when you're in midair, spread your wings and flap them. The owl cloak I gave you should take care of the rest. Go, Otis. Show me what you can do. Alright, cannon will do. Alright, you're flying. Now try and move around a bit. See that platform up there? Yeah, I see it. Fly up there and land on that island. Then I'll teach you the real tricks. Alright, we can do it. Let's do this thing. I can't go any higher. I don't know what's up with that. Well, Otis, that was some terrible flying. I have to say, I'm really disappointed. Most students pick this up instantly. Tomorrow we'll go back to your normal studies. It pains me to see such inept flying. Quickly, Otis. People need our help. The drought isn't as patient with your sluggishness as I am. I've left that water jug on the ground. Pick it up immediately. Hurry up. Okay, I'm hurrying. Okay, I got it. Hang on. They've been sloshing the jug around. Let me check if there's any water left. Put the jug down here. No! I told you to put it down, not to smash it. How are we supposed to bring water to the villagers now? I will not forget this. I will make sure that the others are aware of what your incompetence has cost us. Do you understand? I cannot describe how disappointed I am in you, Otis. Leave me. I'll bring water to Ville myself. Otis, you have failed me again and again and again. Today, there are no lessons. All you need to do today is talk to the other villagers. Simple enough, right? Even for you. Have them tell you what they think of you and your ineptitude. Don't come back to me until you know what you need to know. Well, what I apparently know is that Professor Snape gets reincarnated into a freaking owl man. And is just as much of a jerk now as he is then. Or sorry, was then. You know what I mean. Poor Otis. Poor mute little owl. Oh, by the by, I cut out a portion here, but yes, he is mute. Not just a voiceless character, but, you know, he is canonically in this game a mute character. Just FYI. This is just kind of generally unpleasant, so I'm going to skip ahead a little bit, okay? One scene transition later. Velly. Or is it Vel? Let's go with Veli. It's actually a rather nice looking area. Look forward to wandering around here later. Otis! What? Don't zone out. Get up here. Hey, it's not my fault. It's the cameraman's fault. He's the one who panned out to see the rest of the area. Not my fault. About time, Otis. We'll be keeping watch over Veli today. There have been pirates about lately. You know the drill. Bortomir the guards. Get to it. Overdramatic jerkwad. Fine, I'll keep watch for pirates. Ooh, hey, there's a thing over here. Let's see, what do we get? Ooh, coins! Nice. I have no idea what I'm gonna spend those on later, but ooh, more coins. Even better. Very nice. Ooh, there's another thing. What's the thing do? Ooh, more coins. Very nice. Definitely got some spending money on me. Very good. And daintily flying through hoops. Very good. What were you doing again? Higher Veli Plaza, lower Otis. Oh, Veli Plaza. Oh, that's right. Pirates. Veli. Nearly forgot about that. Totally on it. I swear. Was not distracted at all. And, hey, buddy. Who are you? Is it just me? Hey man, keeping watch today? Yeah, that's totally what I was doing and nothing else. Maybe you want to do something later? Otis and Getty, the unstoppable team. Maybe we should take that trip to Advent today. Advent? Let me know when you're done. I'll be fixing this cannon. Gotta be prepared for anything, right? Yeah, you sure get that cannon fixed? I mean, it's not like we're gonna be attacked by pirates later or anything like that. That'd just be ridiculous.
Oh no! Pirates!
What, who? Are those pirates out there?
Oh no! Pirates!
Why didn't Getty fix that cannon? It was our only line of defense! Why, Getty? Why did you doom us all?
Oh my gosh. I don't believe it. We found him. The casual bongos guy. Remember? From Five Nights at Freddy's sister location? Remember? From the elevator? The casual bongos thing? We found him. We finally found him. Sir, I am a huge fan. Thank you for taking this time to talk to me. Thank you. Just thank you so very much. Sure, I'm glad I have plenty of time to do this and have no other concerns whatsoever in this game. Hey guys, remember 5 seconds ago when I said I had no other concerns or worries about things in this game? Turns out you do! I totally forgot. Whoopsie! Anywho, let's go ahead straight to, actually fighting things, because as it turns out, in platformers, you have to do that sometimes. Who knew? Crazy, right? Is that a Yeti? I think that's a Yeti. Okay, we're being attacked by Yetis, okay. Wow. You killed him, Getty. That's actually pretty impressive. You know what? I apologize, Getty. I judged you too harshly. All this time, I thought you were just some weird tingle lookalike character in this game, but you know what? You're your own guy. And you know what? You're actually pretty cool. If it were not for you, I'd probably be dead right about now. So thank you. Thank you very much. You know what, Getty? I think you're right. You and me, we are an unstoppable team. With our skills together, no one could stop us. Ooh, is that a rock? Let's see. Oh, okay, I'm supposed to destroy the barrier with it. Booyah! Why, yes. I don't think anything could break us apart. Not even a giant, funky-looking stage boss with multiple forms. Haha, yes, we've got you on the ropes now. What are you gonna do about that? Oh, hey, look at that. A giant, funky-looking stage boss with multiple forms. Alright, see you later, buddy! And that, ladies and gentlemen, was Owlboy. A fantastic side-scrolling, well, I'd call it a platformer, but that doesn't exactly sound right. You're not jumping from platform to platform exactly. But it is kind of a platformer. Actually, the way I was playing it, it was a little bit of a shmup, too. But let's not get too much into nitpicking on that one. Regardless of whatever the devil genre it's supposed to be, it's extremely enjoyable. I enjoyed it immensely. And in the 3-ish years that I've been doing this show, this is the second time that I would ever give a game a gold award. And this one has most assuredly earned it. If you're a fan of platformers, if you're a fan of pixelated graphics, if you are a fan of charming worlds, quirky characters, any of that stuff, if you saw any part of this review and thought, hey, that game looks interesting, you'll probably love this game. So, why not give it a try? This one is already out on PC, has been for about a year, and will, in the very near future, probably within the next 48 hours after this review goes up, will be showing up on the electronic storefronts for the PlayStation and the Switch. So, pick it up, because dear Lord, it is worth it. This one runs for about $25, and for a platformer of this caliber, you can certainly do a hell of a lot worse for $25. So, give it a try. Oh, and in case you're wondering, there is at least one other character other than Getty that has his back in Veli, and this is him. Well, that's pretty much everything for this episode, but there's one last niggling little detail I'd like to get out of the way. This game, it's made pretty clear and obvious that there are humans, in addition to being owl people. And we see, at least through depictions in art and what have you, that clearly there must have, if not right now, then at some point in the past, been actual, factual, true owls. Which begs the question, how exactly are there owl people? I think I have a theory. A toyful boyfriend. Oh yeah, that's right, I'm going there. A toyful freaking boyfriend. Yes, a game which has you, a human female, dating birds. You want owl boys? Because that's how you get owl boys. Okay, I'm sorry. I had to rant about that, at least just for a brief moment. I apologize. I lost my cool for a moment there, but I've got it back now. Anyways, that does it for me this week, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. I certainly enjoyed making it for you. If you enjoyed it, hit that like button. If you'd like to see more reviews like this one in the future for various indie games or other silly nonsense by me, then hit that subscribe button and hit that notification bell to make absolutely certain you get updated the moment any of my new content goes up. And if you're looking for some other videos by yours truly, well then how about these? Over here, you can check out my review from last week for Rivals of Aether. And over here, you can check out my review for what I believe to be the prequel to this game, Hatoyful Boyfriend. Check out either one, they're both fantastic, just like you guys have been. Till the next time we meet, this is Master RBG, signing off.